My name is Nathan Yong. I'm a furniture designer and I also sell furniture. When I was young, I'm surrounded by neighbors and relatives that listen to Chinese ballad. And I used to like them and wanted to be a singer. It's very funny now that I think of it. So when I reached my teens, I worked in a CD shop. And from there, I got to know new wave, 80s new wave music, and then after indie music from there, yeah. I think for me, music kind of reminds me of my youth in the past. Like, there's a sense of innocence when I listen to music. It's like playtime and there's no worries. It's just, especially when I listen to indie, a lot of jangling and all that. So it takes the stress off from me, yeah. And music is like also like perfume to me. Like you remember a certain part of your life when you listen to, oh, this music was 1987 and I was doing that with this friend at somewhere, barbecuing at East Coast and all that. So I like it. It's like a documentation to my life in that sense. So now for listening to new music is to document my current life and situation. Yeah. Yes, I play drums. Oh, no, I went to Yamaha Music School, but I only play about a year. Yeah. I actually listen to Black Keys, the Black Keys, and I don't know, the drum beat just sets me say I need to learn drum. I tried to learn guitars, but I failed twice. I think guitar is not my thing. But lo and behold, I can play drums now. So that should be a long-term thing. So every Sunday, I'll like play with friends and then go to school and learn. And I only play on Sundays. So I'm a Sunday drummer. I think it was good because I think every kid should at least experience music in their life before and see whether they like it or not. I think music, kids are born to be creative, and then it's whether you can nurture it, you know, or in the end they choose to be more academic rather than with music, and they should be given a chance. And children that's at disadvantage should have the chance to experience music, be it that they learn about music instrument or something that has got to do with music. So, and a lot of kids in Singapore are stressed out with academic performance, and not every kid is academically inclined. Some is more musically inclined, and we should give them a chance to explore that with this single out. I chose the Stone Roses, I Wanna Be Your Door, because that was 1989. I saw the album when I was working in a CD shop, and I played, and the first song just built up and escalate. And the thing is, the lyrics just repeat, you know, I don't need to sell my soul, it's already in me. And the whole song is just that lyrics. And for me, it's so strong as a whip when you're a teen. I was like, you know, 17 years old. So, and that was part of my quest for more indie bands and all that. And I liked Stone Roses' whole album, but the first song, I Wanna Be A Doll, kind of the soundtrack of my life at that time, I Wanna Be A Doll, you know. Oh, I think the song is, I mean, the lyrics is very simple, repeated, very direct, and yet very strong. So I thought a white background with a black brushstroke would be able to succinctly put the message across, and there's no need to over design or over emphasize, because the word and the starkness of black and white were able to deliver that feeling, I think. Yeah.